قوم کا فخر ہے اور اپنی دشمن کی کسی بھی کاروائی سے نمٹنے کی بھرپور صلاحیت رکھتی ہے اور اب صدر پاکستان آج کی اس تقریب سے خطاب کریں گے
بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم ایئر چیف مارشل مجاہد انور خان صاحب چیف آف ایئر آف دی ایئر اسٹاف پاکستان ایئر فورس گورنر آف سندھ ہز ایکسلنسی مسٹر عمران اسماعیل چیئرمین جوائنٹ چیف آف اسٹاف کمیٹی جنرل زبیر محمود حیات صاحب ایکسلنسیز ڈپلومیٹس ڈسٹنگوئڈ گیسٹ لیڈیز اینڈ جینٹلمین السلام علیکم آئی ایم آنرڈ ٹو وٹنس سچ این امپریسو فائر پاور ڈیمانسٹریشن بائی دا فائٹر ایئر کرافٹ آف پاکستان ایئر فورس ٹوڈے Today's event not only represents the enormous potential of PAF's frontline fleet, but also indicates the unparalleled professionalism, incomparable skill and matchless teamwork of our brave air warriors. I take this opportunity to extend my profound felicitations to Chief of the Air Staff, Pakistan Air Force, on the success of the memorable event. I have been told that the occasion also marks the culmination of the Inter-Squadron Armament Competition 2019, in which PAF combat squadrons made strenuous endeavors to attain excellence in a healthy, competitive environment. I sincerely appreciate and can rightly feel the exemplary dedication and unremitting enthusiasm of PAF personnel which made this landmark achievement possible. We all know that Pakistan Air Force has a proud history of defending the country's aerial frontiers. The unmatched valor and audacity displayed by our PAF heroes over the years have upheld the sky's vision of the PAF being second to none. I feel elated after watching this awesome demonstration of our sophisticated aerial platforms and marksmen. Engaging targets with pinpoint precision. Today's thrilling performance by our Shaheens further enhances the nation's faith and trust in the strength of Pakistan Air Force. I am confident that in future too, PAF would continue to strive for eminence and as always live up to its glorious traditions of valor and professionalism. It is also gratifying that Pakistan Air Force strongly believes in self-sustenance and pursuing modernization through indigenization. The hallmark of PAF's indigenous effort is state-of-the-art and battle-tested JF-17 Thunder, the pride of Pakistan. And in the end, I will narrate an anecdote which will make us proud further. The platform has displayed its capabilities during the recent engagement on our eastern border. The aircraft has also proven worthy of its pride during the demonstration that we have witnessed today. I am pleased that PAF has embarked upon the strategic project of establishing the Aviation City and National Aerospace Science and Technology Park at Kamra. The facilities hold rewarding prospects for promoting the much needed industry-academia linkage and would serve as home to the country's aviation industry. I am glad to know that a number of friendly countries have shown interest to invest in this mega project and we look forward to potential partners for collaboration in this venture. Ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan wishes to maintain peaceful relations with our other nations, especially our neighbors. Yet, we are not oblivious to safeguarding a national interest and sovereignty. I am confident that the armed forces of Pakistan are ready to face any internal or external challenge. They stood in complete synergy during our two-decade-long war on terror and arrested threats on our western border. We have also amply demonstrated our resolve and capability against any aggression, and the entire world also witnessed our response to India's violation of Pakistan airspace in February 2019. When PAF once again proved its mettle in the air battle over Kashmir and re-established its deterrence and fear in the hearts of the enemy. Pakistan will always stand by the people of Kashmir in their just struggle for self-determination. We urge the international community to bring an end to human atrocities and curfew in Indian-occupied Kashmir and expedite resolution of Kashmir issue in accordance with the United Nations resolutions. Kashmiris trusted the world community in the 50s, and therefore they demand a resolution of their trust also. In the end, I extend my heartiest gratitude to Chief of the Air Staff for inviting me to this important operational activity. I deeply commend the devotion of PF's combat and support elements involved in the preparation of this mega event. I would urge PF to continue working with the same zeal and enthusiasm. The nation believes in your capability and more so in your courage, commitment and determination. I also pray for your continued success in future endeavors. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all, and may you have safe landings always. But there are three anecdotes which I must narrate. There is a fascination and romance with the Pakistan Air Force of all citizens of Pakistan. And I still remember as a child with my father probably in the late 50s visiting Boripur Air Base and seeing an air show at that time. I have seen a lot over the last 70 years which gives us pride in Pakistan, and especially during the recent skirmish. And I must tell you, in the last few weeks I have been to Tokyo and Baku and I have met international leaders, and I assure you there is a change in the air, and that change is because of our performance. They are fascinated by what happened. Even one president, I can't name the country, he said he wants to fly a JF-17 because he has heard so much about the JF-17. These are the intangibles which are happening, and therefore I'm glad that it was mentioned that there is an evolving trend with new technologies coming to the fore with hybrid kind of warfare, and Pakistan Air Force is aware of that and in fact makes preparations for that. Most of the ammunitions we saw on display today here were self-produced. And young officers and pilots, I am proud of you. I must say that. You have made Pakistan proud. Our enemies are under fear, and they recently blamed their aircraft platforms for their poor performance. It is remarkable how nicely you have demonstrated the fact that despite armaments making progress, is still the human platform which will always remain important, and that is where I am proud of you young officers who fly our aircraft and ensure that Pakistan stays safe and Pakistan gradually moves towards the greatness which Pakistan deserves. Thank you, gentlemen. Thank you very much.